Rocks don't come with birth certificates, yet geologists talk about rocks forming thousands, millions, or even billions of years ago. Do you ever wonder how we know the age of a rock? Welcome to Geoscience Australia's Education Centre, located on Ngunnawal and Ngambri land. My name is Emily, and today we're going to explore the two main ways that scientists determine the age of a rock: relative dating and absolute dating. Relative dating is used to reconstruct the order of past events without knowing the exact age of a rock. To find out whether a rock is younger or older than another, scientists will observe patterns and relationships between rock layers. Sediment, like sand and silt, gets transported by rivers and streams. And when they reach a calm environment, like an ocean, they get deposited at the bottom in layers. This container in front of me represents the ocean floor. When I add some sand to this container, we can see that the sand falls through the water and is deposited on the bottom in a flat layer, on top of the pre-existing older layers. Over millions of years, these loose sediments can turn into a sedimentary rock like this. We know from looking at this rock and the environment it may have formed in, that these layers must have been originally deposited like this, horizontally, and that the layer on top must be younger than all of the layers below. This demonstrates two laws used in relative dating: the law of original horizontality and the law of superposition. If these rock layers were to contain fossils, it can provide scientists with even more information about the relative age of the rock. When fossils are abundant, widely distributed, and only appear for a short and distinct amount of time, they are called index fossils. For example, this trilobite, Redlichia tacuensis, is an index fossil. It only appears in rocks between 514 and 509 million years old, and serves as a marker for rocks of the same age all around the world. This one is found on Kangaroo Island in South Australia, and can also be found in the Guizhou province in South China. But how do scientists put an exact age on a rock? Well, they use absolute dating. In the late 1890s, scientists discovered radioactivity, where some atoms in nature spontaneously change or decay to more stable atoms over time. When molten rock cools, tiny minerals form. And during this process, some of these radioactive atoms become trapped inside of the minerals. Over time, these atoms slowly decay into more stable atoms. Scientists know how long this process takes for each radioactive atom, and refer to this as its half-life. The half-life is the amount of time it takes for half of the original radioactive atom to change into the decay product. If we know the proportion of the original radioactive atom compared to its decay product, we can use a radioactive decay curve. In this example, we know we have 50%. So we can figure out how long this process has been happening for, and therefore the age of the mineral. A special instrument called a mass spectrometer is used to make these measurements. Now, not all radioactive atoms decay at the same rate. This is the geological timescale of the Earth, and it can be used to help us visualize the half-lives of two different radioactive atoms, carbon-14 and uranium-238. You might have heard of carbon dating, which looks at the decay of carbon-14. Carbon-14 has a half-life of around 5,700 years, which means it can be used to date material up to about 50,000 years old. So carbon dating is commonly used to date things within human history, like bones and other archaeological objects. But what about anything older than this? Uranium-238 has a half-life of 4.5 billion years. Looking at the geological timescale, This means it can be used to date material across the entire history of the Earth. In fact, uranium-238 was one of the radioactive atoms that scientists used to measure the world's oldest zircon mineral grain from the Jack Hills conglomerate in Western Australia. These grains are 4.4 billion years old. That's really, really old, almost as old as the Earth itself. Today we've learnt about relative dating, which all of us can do by making observations, and absolute dating, which scientists use to measure the exact age of a rock or mineral. Relative dating and absolute dating are both essential tools that we use to reconstruct Earth's complex history.